Hey guys, so in a couple of weeks, or maybe next week, or I don't really know how soon or how late it's going to be, but it has to be before September 3rd, I think. I will be leaving Tennessee, my parents' home, and heading back to my apartment in New York. And that's the plan. I will be starting graduate school pretty soon to attain my MSW, I know, which is, for any of you out there who watched my video about my student debt situation, yeah, it's pretty crazy that I have such a huge debt, and I'm going to add to it by going to graduate school. I'll talk more about that maybe later in this video or probably another video. But anyway, that was the plan was for my dad to go with me, take a bus, Greyhound, which takes us to Ohio, Cincinnati, Ohio, and then from there, it actually allows us to transfer to an Amtrak and then take a train ride to Penn Station, New York City, which sounded much better to me than just a straight 17-hour bus ride from Nashville, Tennessee to Allen Street in New York City. I mean, it's faster that way, but train, much more comfortable. And from my experience, Greyhound has always been more comfortable than the Mega Bus or the Chinatown Bus. But that was the plan. But it seems like my dad has got some things he's got to take care of or some things he's waiting on, so he's not able to go with me. And it turns out me too, something has come up with me too. With graduate school for social work, actually just for social work major, in whether it's undergraduate or graduate, internship is a required thing, it's a mandated thing. For the undergraduate, if you're getting a bachelor's in social work, internship is a requirement in a senior year of your college degree, so your fourth year. In some schools, you have internships in your junior year, and those schools are much more, I don't know, they tend to be much more expensive, much more private, much more renowned, I suppose. I don't know if the renowned thing is really true, but I went to NYU, and junior year field placement was a requirement. So I did internship on my third year and fourth year as an undergraduate, to attain my BSW. I interned at Housing Works, which is an organization that provides services to people who have HIV and AIDS. Currently, Housing Works has expanded, so they now serve a lot more diverse group of population, which is cool. But they are the largest grassroots organization in the United States that provides housing and other various services to people living with HIV and AIDS. So, really awesome organization. I interned there. I also interned at Chelsea. God, the name is long, but it's Hudson Group, Chelsea Housing. Totally forgot the name for a second. Hudson Guilds, Chelsea Housing Group. Yeah, which is now defunct. Hudson Guilds is still long running, but they defunded Chelsea Housing Group. But that was really for tenants living in rent control and rent stabilized apartments and providing advocacy services to them. I interned there for a while, and then it got defunct and defunded. But yeah, internships are a requirement. Of course, with a graduate degree, internships are required for all the years of your graduate education. I'm in a two-year program. Things happen that way. In my case, it really should have been a one-year program, but something's happened. So I'm in a two-year program. Well, not something's happened, but really, during my undergraduate years, I withdrew from a class after a certain time passes that is left on the record. And apparently, withdrawing a class disqualifies me from the advanced standing program for the graduate program, which is the advanced standing program allows you to get your master's degree within 1 year. And I was disqualified from that because I withdrew from a class. And also, maybe because my GPA wasn't high enough, but that is arguable because it's right about almost there. But it's having withdrawn from two classes, I think. Yeah, so that was what really disqualified me, but I still got accepted into the two-year program, so I'll graduate from graduate school within 2 years. Anyway, internships are required, and they placed me already, and I had to make contact and be interviewed with the agency that I will be interning for, and they wanted the interview to happen this Friday, but I really wanted to kind of just be with my parents until September 3rd, so I told them that. But if it turns out that They need me earlier than September 3rd, and I would actually have to go back to New York earlier than I planned. I start school on September 7th. So that's kind of the deal with me. It's kind of exciting, actually, to... I don't know, it's... I haven't been in school for over 3 years. You know, I finished college with an undergrad, with a bachelor's in social work, more than 3 years ago now, in 2010. So this is kind of, I don't know, I'm a little nervous, I'm a little excited, not quite sure which. I guess the usual thing that happens with, you know, people with in the social work field, I don't know if the usual is the right word, but the people, my colleagues, they usually went straight to graduate school. So they finished their college, their undergraduate, and then they went straight to graduate school, and they went into advanced study program, and they graduated within a year, and they have a master's, and they start their licensing procedure. A lot of people already, a lot of the colleagues that I know that I studied with NYU, seem to have already gotten their master's. So I'm kind of slow at this point. I spent 3 years in the real world. I don't even know what that means, but doing all sorts of odd kind of jobs, tutoring, working at a homeless shelter, canvassing. I think that's pretty much it. There's some odd jobs here and here and transcribing, whatnot, but yeah, you know, living by myself in the apartment and paying rent, trying to do jobs that I think would help me in my career. Couldn't be social work jobs, because in New York City, in New York State, like with many other states in the United States, you can't be a social worker unless you have a licensed master's in social work degree, like master's degree in social work. And I have a bachelor's, so I'm not qualified. So the jobs that I did with the BSW are jobs that required a high school degree or a GED. So yeah, totally beneath my level, but really that's because I have no I had no experience other than my internship, which is what I was afraid of. The reason I didn't go straight into graduate school after graduating from undergraduate, there are a lot of reasons. I mean, the biggest reason was because after I graduated with a bachelor's, oh my god, I have this humongous debt. You know, I kind of want to pay back a bit of it before I go to graduate school and make the debt even bigger. You know, that was kind of one reason, which most of you would agree are sensible reasons. A lot of people who commented on my, you know, I owe Citibank $105,000. Most people who commented on that was like, you don't need a college degree to help people. That's ridiculous. You shouldn't have paid that much for worthless liberal arts social work degree. So those people would definitely agree that going straight into graduate school and accruing even more student debt would probably not be a good idea. But it ultimately, that's what I have to do if I want to pursue social work, because to be a social worker, you need a master's degree. It's just a fact. Unless I was planning to start up an office in a rural state like Tennessee, which requires only a bachelor's, but then it would still be hard because they really look for people with years and years of experience, which I did not have right after I graduated from NYU. So again, you know, those kind of things. So I was afraid of going straight to master's and going straight to graduate school and graduating from it and not having any experience at all in the real world. And just having on my resume like, oh, I have a master's degree and I have a couple of experience in these internship programs at NYU placed me. And I was really afraid of just being really hard to find a job that fits, even with the master's. That was the fear. That's why I was like, no, I'm going to graduate and I'm going to try to get actual work experience with my bachelor's first. And then after things, you know, after I start paying back a bit of my debt, then I'll go into graduate school, accrue even more debt somehow, and, you know, graduate with the master's in social work. It's been a long process, and honestly, there were times when I was just like, you know, shoot, I should just give up social work altogether and do something else. It's been testing, you know, and in some ways, when I was working at the homeless shelter, I was just like, you know, I could just work at this homeless shelter for a long time, for 10 years or whatever, and go to Peace Corps and go to another country and do nonprofit work like that with just a bachelor's in social work. That would be perfectly okay with me. There were some times when I thought like that. But of course, then, you know, my job with the homeless shelter, that ended. And then I was kind of in a limbo, not knowing what to do. It was at that time that I applied to NYU again, because all the deadlines for the other graduate schools were closed, in New York at least, because I wanted to stay in New York. Still, to me, I feel like having been in New York City, the social work opportunities in social work opportunities in New York City are immense. There's a lot of opportunities for aspiring social workers here. A lot to learn, a lot of great nonprofit organizations, a lot of great social work opportunities, really. So it's kind of why I want to stay here and do it. So I've been here 3 years, just kind of wandering, and now I'm starting graduate school, whereas all my colleagues have finished theirs or are entering the social work realm. So that's, you know, I'm really happy for them. Some people, I realize, you know, through Facebook, we can kind of like Facebook stalk people now, which is kind of weird. But it's something that I guess is permissible. I don't know. But it seems like some people have kind of gone to a different path altogether. Some are kind of unfortunate a little bit. One became like a bus driver. That's interesting. But not too unusual in this field. In this field, people get burnt out. And so when they change their field, they go from social work into something totally, totally, totally different. So there's that one person I think is going to college again, but for a business degree. Go figure. I'm still pursuing social work, and there are many other success stories too. You know, some people went on to do nonprofit lectures across the country, helped out an orphanage in Haiti. There's a lot of awesome colleagues that I know of, just judging from like their LinkedIn profiles and from their Facebook. I feel really grateful to have studied in college with those amazing group of people. Don't really know, but anyway, yeah. This whole thing is weird. Also, another thing, I haven't been a student in a long time. So again, the first year in my 2-year program is exactly the same as my 4th year in my undergraduate. So I'm taking the same courses that I've taken before. Should be easy. The internship sounds pretty exciting if I get placed into this specific one. I've been considered for a placement at this organization called Partnership with Children. And it seems to me like what they do is they connect with schools that, are in the districts where it's like, you know, the lower funded, the badly funded, or the schools that are badly funded serve the needs of the underprivileged people in the lower income areas, and just connecting, going to those schools and advocating for the students there and connecting them with the resources is that kind of organization, which is really cool, because I like working with children. I want to have more experience working with teachers and with parents. That would be a great experience to build as I go into my social work career. One thing that kind of is on my mind, though, is NYU, is their social work is more clinical than most other schools. By that, I mean their curriculum is more focused towards those who are going to be like psychotherapists or therapists or counselors, that kind of thing, or hospital social workers, which is not really the area that I would like to go into, you know, with the social work degree, but I think it would be helpful. Many other schools, each schools have their own kind of like focus, you know. Columbia University has a focus on like administration and public policy. So those kind of social workers, some of them, like a good portion of them, usually graduate college and they go to law school and they do like public policy work with a social work background. So those are those kinds of people too. Which actually sounds pretty awesome, but I don't think I want to go to law school and accrue even more debt. But yeah. Oh, and also this time around, I did get more loans again, and kind of feeling a little bit ambivalent about this one. I'm excited that I have this loan to be able to pay for my college education, graduate education, and to pay for my living expenses and pay back some of my debt that I already have with this debt. But it is a, I this time around, I didn't get it from private banks. Because my student debt that I got when I was an undergraduate, you know, to graduate from it, was from Citibank. And now some of my loans are with Discover Bank. Private banks. This time, my loans are from the U.S. government. That makes me feel a little ambivalent. Because, you know, before, people could comment on my video and be like, oh my gosh, you're the reason the country is going bankrupt. You're stealing from our nation. Our tax dollars are going into you so you can become, you can study a worthless degree like a social work degree. And, you know, those kind of comments, I could always just kind of say confidently, well, no, none of your tax dollars have gone to me for my education. Those are from private banks, and they might have stolen your tax money to fund me, but it's from the private banks, not from the government. This time around, I can't really say that confidently because I am borrowing money from the government. It's actually much better for me because private banks are very inflexible with their payment plans. They're like, you pay me in 10 years this amount every month, and can't really argue with that. There's no refinancing options. There's no options at all. It's, you know, but with government loans, there's a lot more flexibility, and that's all I really ask for. And their interest rates are much lower. I have three loans with Citibank and Discover, and two of my loans are at a really great interest rate. There's like 2%. But there's one loan that's like 8%. So that sucks. But so hopefully, you know, I have Discover loan. They're low interest. And there's definitely more options once I graduate with government loans. There's an option where I can take a government job or really good nonprofit job. And I do a couple of years and my loans will be forgiven or something like that. There's definitely a lot more options with government loans. But it feels kind of weird to have taken money from the government. It was allowed this time. The first time it wasn't allowed because of, you know, I was a dependent to my parents, and my parents at that time were their income was pretty damn high. We were considered upper middle class, or maybe even just upper class. My mom's salary was, you know, over $100,000 a year, so. It's kind of the reason why I wasn't eligible for any government loans. No PLUS loans, no direct loans, nothing like that. Because my family's income was pretty big enough. That's why I had to go to private banks. This time around, I did the tax report. My mom's, I'm no longer dependent, but I still have to, you know, report my mom's income status. She's working as a nurse in Tennessee, which doesn't pay nearly as much as a hospital in California where she used to work. So her income is much lower. Actually, I think when I did the FAFSA, my mom wasn't working. So she didn't have an income. My dad was working as a pastor. And pastor's income, very, very low. I think pastors make, actually, yeah, they do. Pastors make much less money than I would as a social worker. I made more money than my dad when I was working at a homeless shelter. So that goes to tell you how low a pastor's salary is. But yeah, that was the financial situation this time. And I wasn't making much money either, so it was just like, I was like, you know, the money situation, the financial situation is so low that we are now eligible for government loans, or I am. So that's kind of how it turned out. It's going to be 2 years, so that's probably going to double the amount of debt that I have now. It's kind of frustrating, because, you know, I paid back a good amount of my debt. And now I'm just going to be back to where I started from in terms of debt after I graduate from college. So it's just like, I've been able to pay back this much. But then back to the beginning of where all this started. But I think, you know, I'm optimistic a bit. The plan, you know, is once I graduate with the master's, the opportunities for social work field really opens up with the master's. And with NYU, they connect you with internships. And that builds experience, and so when I get out with the master's, I'll have a master's, and I'll have a bunch of experience to put on my resume. I mean, I now have worked at a homeless shelter, I worked in an organization that served the needs of people living with HIV and AIDS, I'll have these 2 years of internships as a graduate student, I'll have written a thesis and a dissertation, so I'm optimistic, but it's, you know, I'm going to accrue a lot of debt. So that's always worrisome. But, you know, the one thing I know is I've been able to, I've been working with my student debt for 3 years now. And I've noticed, you know, if I have a stable job, I'm able to make, you know, I can try to do my living however I can. I can make the monthly payment. And if I can just do that, that's really enough for me. I don't have to make a humongous amount of money because, you know, I'm not a big money spender anyway. And, you know, I like the simple things in life usually. So I don't spend that much money. And so, I don't know. Hopeful, optimistic, kind of nervous, kind of really excited, but we'll see. I'm going back to school again. It's going to start again in 2 weeks. Anyway, that's a long channel update. Next time I do a channel update, I'll probably be in my apartment in New York City, and I'll probably be a student again, and I haven't been one in 3 years. So there's that. Hope you guys enjoyed whatever this was. Cheers.